On the spot news media, we got the latest news. We don't care about the views, we just representing right. Put local news internationally every night. On the spot, wave that Jamaican flag from left to right. Let's get it right, y'all know the type. We ain't dealing with the hype. We make it take flight.
Yeah, man, my viewers and subscribers, what a go on. A blessed and wonderful Saturday morning to each and every person out there tuning in to On The Spot News Media. And you don't know how we do it over on this side each and every morning. We have to give thanks and praise to the Most High Creator for the preservation of life, because life is indeed the greatest. And you don't know the hashtag for 2022, preservation of life. So this morning, for those who keep in the Sabbath and traversing the church, you don't know, keep On The Spot News Media as viewers, subscribers, members of Jan Public, and members of the diaspora in your immediate prayers, because we need that now more than ever. Yeah, man, me I tell you. And for those who traverse into the market, if you go get a little market goods, you don't know, tomorrow red rice and roaster day, today are the official soup day. Yeah, man, you don't know, safe travel pan the gravel. And for those who just the out and about, safe travel in these streets, same way. Yeah, man. So watch this now, my peeps. Thursday night, a little knockings and clappings go on right at the intersection of King Street and North Street. There, so that fall within the premits of the Kingston Central Police Division. Yesterday morning, I would have spoken briefly on that incident that two bodies were thrown from a pro box right at the intersection right there. So one man pred out, gone a shot eye country land, no longer amongst the land of the living. Another one did dead there, gap, and eventually lose him 3 points too. So we get the identity of one of the men so far. This is the person right now on your screen. He has been identified as Anthony Palmer, otherwise known as Bird. Yeah, man, come from Riverview in the Papin area. So it kind of puzzling what really a go on and how the loss of life of them two man there end up way down there, so almost in a downtown basically. Because for those who know, North Street, King Street intersection is just a stone throw away from downtown Kingston, just a stone throw away from the mother's party place right there, so right behind the park. Yeah, man. So that one the kind of puzzling and rather troubling, because the brother come from way up a Riverview in a Papin. So for those who don't know where Riverview is in Papin, when you reach in a Papin Square and like you're going up Garden Town Road, just little bit topside the Fish Eye Clinic there, so you don't know that little eyeglass place the right there, so, and the Papin School the right half there, so a little right turn the right half there, so when you go down the right turn there, and down there, so Riverview would have there. So we get to understand, say, this brother here is a little hustler still in the street. Not really a dirty kind of boy, but is a man who juggle every little thing in little ganja. You don't know, him buy and sell one little car more time, him run taxi. Is a man who just ever dig it in the streets, so to speak, and I try to make ends meet. So everybody puzzled, everybody here open my mouth, drop a grung, I wonder what really go on with Bird. What really make the man them clip Bird wing and dash him out there just like a rag doll, me I tell you. The man then deal with the scene crab it. Yeah, man, me I tell you. Man them a move like them mother a crab and them father a rabbit. Crab it. I saw the man them a deal with the thing in the street. So right now, we don't understand what really take place with Bird. And the other man, we get thrown out of the character with Bird, is still unidentified. We still a work on the identity of that other male figure. And within another few hours now, just topside which part, them man they get fling away, you know, a female get slap away. Boy, may I tell you, in the Kingston Central Police Division there, a move wham. So basically within 24 hours, Kingston Central get 3 loss of life. Just like that. Yeah, man, may I tell you. So the police report as it relates to that loss of life is stating that an unidentified woman get a whole heap of corn to her skin and end up lose her 3 points, courtesy of the old dirty corner boy them at her residence along Mark Lane in Fletcher's Land, Kingston. So you don't know, say Mark Lane run from way down a town and go straight up in a Fletcher's Land. So this knockings and clappings incident occurred about minutes after one. And as I said earlier, this is the third loss of life recorded in the Kingston Central Police Division within a few hours. Yeah man, me I tell you. So the police them still not identify the woman as yet, but all we know, she's no longer amongst the land that they live in. So Superintendent Linval Phoenix, who is the head of operations in the Kingston Central Police Division, have stated that men that was listed as persons of interest basically start turning themselves to the police and is presently being interviewed. So him basically has him a reap some success from those street meetings and him calling out these men to turn in themselves to the police. So me could see how that work out, no? Yeah man. So right now we're gonna flick it over there in a Linstead, St. Catherine, where Linstead record its first loss of life. Of course, courtesy of the old dirty kind of boy them. So watch this now, my peeps. Just a day after being released from police custody, 27-year-old Denton Hamilton from 4th Street became Linstead's first loss of life victim since the start of the new year. So according to the Jamaica Constabulary Force, Hamilton was taken out by the hands of the old dirty corner boy them whilst he was in a beauty salon in the community shortly after noon on Thursday. He was pronounced you know what at the hospital. But head of the St. Catherine North Police Division, Superintendent Howard Chambers, told the news team that he had been arrested and charged in relation to a recent case of aggravated robbery. So the lawmen them a wonder if is a case where because him do that and come out back into the streets now, them people put a hit on him head and slap him away. So right now, police is definitely investigating the loss of life of the 27-year-old Denton Hamilton. So watch this now, my peeps. We are going to go over there in a Ryan Park, in a Mobile St. James. And this story is rather a bizarre one. One of them stories that were just... Jano, just have your way. Have your thinking away. You see, because of the crime and violence in our country, everybody is on total edge. Nobody nah itch, nobody nah sleep, nobody nah make no mistake because a man a try to preserve him life by whatever means necessary. And unfortunately, this type of unease would have made this man meet his demise in a very unusual circumstances and chain of events. So, why, Jano, that one that really shake me a little way still, me nah lie. Because his father end up take the life of him son. So on your screen is Akeem Taylor, who was reportedly can up basically by his own father. So the whole incident occurred sometime yesterday. And me I go make you know the whole details of how this end up happen. So the St. James Police Division is investigating the circumstances which led to the knockings and clappings loss of life of a man in Ryan Park earlier on yesterday morning. So based on information gathered, the man who lose him 3 pints is Akeem Taylor. Akeem Taylor gets some corn to him skin, but boy, may I tell you, he's not a old dirty corner boy, corn him up. Unfortunately, the man who corn him up was his father. The lawmen describe this as a much unfortunate circumstance and situation. So it is alleged that approximately 5:40 a.m., Taylor's father, a popular St. James businessman, upon seeing a shadow on the roof of his house, opened fire and injured the man. After further investigations, it was revealed that the victim, Taylor, was the adult son of the businessman. The police were called into the scene and Taylor was transported to the Cornwall Regional Hospital where he later succumbed to his injuries. I can just imagine how this father feel. If you know, say, him feel, say, is probably a man a try for broke in, I don't know that intruder something there. And you don't know, say, I mobby you that. Where from you see certain things, you have to take due course action, or else you might end up on the other side of the fence. But when him look and see, say, I'm son lie down the pandotti, me can just imagine him feeling himself all to the day. For no say him end up taking own a son life. But boy, really an unfortunate incident indeed. I would just hope that police investigations can boy prove say boy just a misadventure, so to speak. And the whole incident was just rather unfortunate. But one would be thinking though, why would Mr. Taylor be on the roof of his father's house at 5:40 a.m.? We really need to ascertain that house and how it look and where the roof is. And I don't know, because there's a lot of things that can be taken from this to really understand this whole issue of seeing a shadow upon roof and him being on the roof so early in the morning. Would I really love to see the set out and layout of the house for really derive some logical conclusion or some logics, something will make sense out of this thing here. Because the whole thing just look a certain type of way. But yeah, remember say you have some type of house where they build with the clothesline pan the roof and things so a man can go pan the roof. So we are wonder if a one of them circumstances there. But as me say, we really need to get more clarity upon this so we can bring it forward to the members of Jan Public so we can get a better understanding of what really took place in that unfortunate incident. Anyway, my peeps, remember to like, share, subscribe to the channel. Stay tuned to On The Spot News Media as I continue to bring you fresh news and updates in subsequent newscasts. On The Spot News Media. Yeah, man.